never claimed to be the best type of rapper, but you have to.
The Funky Uncle, aka Ricky Powell. How are you?
He is the quintessential street art photographer.
Yo, listen, we right here live.
All of his photography is essentially shot from inside the culture out.
You know, Ricky was funny. He was an enigmatic kind of guy, you know? He'd be around and not be around. Never knew he was around. He kind of was like real quiet, real low key.
And after a while, people forget that the camera's there.
He got remarkable, casual, unposed photos.
So turn the volume up a notch and watch them.
In this city, every borough, every bridge, every block has a story to tell.
So much music came out of that little neighborhood. The Yeah Yeah Yeahs, the Strokes, Lady Gaga, Nora Jones.
From its garages, punk screamed.
When I would go out to the CBGB's, Joey Ramone was always there.
On its streets, hip-hop was born.
They popped up the ASAP legacy.
And a legend was silenced.
Same young man who has gotten his autograph pulls out a pistol and unloads 5 rounds into John Lennon's back.
From Studio 54 to the Chelsea Hotel, music is all around us. You just have to know where to look. See the whole story only on Spotify. And music happens here.
For me and LP to travel the world now and have thousands and thousands of people screaming our name and screaming Run the Jewels, it just shows me that the risk was worth the reward. I won't be confined. You have to be like a wild, hungry animal. And that doesn't mean vicious and out of control, but that means calculated, focused on getting that meal. I never wanted to only depend on rap to the point if it disappointed me, I just wanted my whole world to wash away. I found something else to be as passionate about.
Jimi Hendrix was hanging out in this location. It was a nightclub called The Generation, and he turned it into a recording studio. After his death, Stevie Wonder moved in. David Bowie, The Stones were there, and Zeppelin was there. Just recently, something that I'm very proud of, we've done works with Beck. My favorite records are being made here.
There's something about the rooms that were built in the 50s, 60s, 70s. They understood sound in a way unique to that time when the Velvet Underground were sort of a manifestation of something in the scene.
I think I first found the Velvet Underground just as a kid bored looking through vinyl records. And my mother casually mentioned that she used to dance with the band when they performed. Felt like this is what I was looking for. There's a dozen songs we could have done. I'm Waiting for the Man just evokes New York in a very particular way.
There was a certain amount of consciousness in myself. It was always a lonely world, not finding people who might think like me, you know?
Very difficult. It's feeling close to Jah. Jah is nearby when you're surfing.
We just feel free.
That's what really draws me to being on my board.
Kids who love surfing, they come here. Skateboarding, links. People who love music come here.
But pre the message, they're just like unifying people.
When you teach a kid how to skate or start a kid surfing and they see that happiness and they develop that love, it's that one love, bro. It's that one connection that each and everybody have together.
Branford and I would meet at different jazz festivals. I remember when I walked into the hotel at North Sea in Rotterdam and I saw Branford. I'm like, oh, there's Branford. And he said, Kurt Elling. And he just stood up, big embrace. And he's like, man, we're making a record together.
A friend of mine, a saxophonist named Paul Carr, said, hey, look, that's Kurt Elling over there. I said, yeah, well, we were talking in Rotterdam. And I said, hey, man, let's do this record. And he goes, yeah, sure, give me a call. And I said, okay. And I say things like that, I mean them.
Branford is funny every day. Anybody who's that creative and with that much imagination and has such a specific take on life is going to be really funny. His friendship means a lot to me. Just to have a friend who I can trust so much.
There's a vibe in New Orleans that is like nothing else.
Here, when the levee breaks. She is a demon.
the Big Easy holds strong.
Katrina hit and the city was transformed.
Whether searching for the House of the Rising Sun or a moon over Bourbon Street.
There's a freedom here that supersedes race, genre, age.
From Mardi Gras masquerades to the parking lots of Lemonade, music is all around us. You just have to know where to look.
My passion is music. But I also have a drive for fashion. Paint my vision with words. And then I paint my vision with fashion. That's the headline, so just have a vision for it.
This is my favorite time when we get together and we're recording or we're performing. We just have so much fun together.
She is nobody's backup singer. For me to think that anybody's backing me up is ridiculous.
I honestly, this is the reason why I love working with this man. Make my
wishes on the stars. The incredible thing about any art is you take something intangible and make it tangible. So you come up with something and then you bring it to fruition. So to write a song, to hear it in your head, to work out an arrangement, come into the studio and build and go, yeah, this is what I envisioned. And to do it in the company that I'm doing it in is incredible. My life is about why not. My life has nothing to do with why. You know, my nose is in front of me, I follow it.
All right, we're jamming. Jamming with you.